Hey, Pastor Steve Waldron, I hope you're having a great day in Jesus. We're going to look at today is what comes next. You know, it's here. I'm doing this, I think it's March 17th. It's a Tuesday, 2020. We're in the midst of this panic, an epidemic, pandemic in the United States of America. It's unlike anything I've ever been a part of. I've lived through 9/11. I've lived through the Iraq War. I lived through Y2K 2008 financial implosion. But I will tell you, this is unique. I was looking on eBay, and Lysol was selling, not just listed, but it was like this sold and this one left for $64.98 for one 19-ounce bottle of Lysol. They were bidding, they had like 14 hours or something left on a thing of Charmin, 12 rolls of Charmin. Now they were mega rolls, but 12 rolls of Charmin, I think it was. The bidding was $158. And I think there was shipping on top of that. I don't think that even came with free shipping. And so I was reminded in the book of Revelation, one of the seals, when the black horse rides, it says that basically, see that the harm not, the oil and the wine, that food was going to cost you a day's wages. And so Sister Walter and I were both reminded of that particular scripture. So what comes next? Does this have anything to do with the book of Revelation? I don't think so. I think that it may be in Matthew 24 when it talks about in a certain time period that they call the beginning of sorrows. Scripture calls the beginning of sorrows. It said there's earthquakes in diverse places. And there, I mean, we had earthquakes in Puerto Rico. I just read headlines, several earthquakes in the northeast United States. We've been having earthquakes in Georgia, North Georgia, thankfully, but in Georgia. And you have a Brevard Fault that runs through here. Oklahoma's been having earthquakes, the West Coast, all this. So, but pestilences. And so this deal that's been going through would qualify, obviously, as a pestilence. And we've really, our church family's been praying to curse it in Jesus' name. We don't want anybody to die from it. We want everybody to be healed in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ and turn to God. But even if they don't turn to God, we want them to be healed in the name of the Lord. But now, what could happen through all this is, because stock market's been tanking, food, nobody can find toilet paper, hand sanitizer, meat in a lot of places just been totally gone, just tons of things, is if it's not careful, I mean, in quarantines and rationing and self-quarantining and can't eat in restaurants, and the president just asked, don't get together for people more than 10 people, you know, a lot of different things like that. That if it eventually like collapses the economy, I could see to where that would bring in a one world currency, like scripture says, and then all the incumbent things that come with the one world currency. And the Bible says when people say peace and safety, then come a sudden destruction on them. And so that could very well happen as well. So, but it's times of panic. You know, I always think about the root word panic comes from pan, which comes from Greek mythology, but is also, most people would say that's of the devil, that he was a type of the devil, that the pan pipes, Ezekiel 28 and all of this type of the devil. So the panic and pandemic and these type things. So, you know, what could very well come next is this emerging new world order, that order out of chaos. Don't let a crisis go to waste. Or it could be something like 2008 system or something else where we just come through it. And this is a blip in history. And a year or two from now, we barely remember it. Just don't know. But this is the reason we should always just live for God. He comes as a thief in the night. Lift up your head, for your redemption draws nigh. We don't know the day or the hour of his coming. We know he's coming soon, you know that old song. So there's different possibilities on what could come next, but we really don't know what's coming next. But Just live for Jesus. And during this time, if we're still in crisis when you're seeing this video, continue to pray, continue to reach out for to the Lord, continue to help others, encourage others, bless others, and God can do anything, and He's able to protect. We've been having our church pray Psalm 91. But though 1,000 fall at your side, 10,000 at your right hand, it shall not come nigh thee. No plague will come nigh your dwelling. And God is a healer. God is the healer. And He loves to heal. And He wants your best. He wants all of our best. He came in the form of His Son. Jesus Christ wanted to admit when He sent His Son, that was God in flesh, and He died for us. One God, one mediator between God and man, the man Christ Jesus. Father and Son, flesh and spirit. And so He wants your best. And as the Church of the Living God, we all want your best as well. So that's just a look at what comes next. We either are laying a groundwork for the fulfillment of the book of Revelation, or this will just be another sign of things to come. As who is that? I forget. H.G. Wells, Signs of Things to Come. And our fire alarm just went off. So we'll see you later. God bless you. Talk with you later in Jesus' name.